Fiesta.
Lively.
Sugar Plum.
Luxury.
40 Lee adhesive tabs and 20 Lee press-on nails for a perfect fit. Lee press-on nails, 18 sensational fashion colors. Press on.
We hope you've enjoyed Illegal. Tomorrow, a gangster commits murder, then uses an innocent fisherman and his boat for refuge. The Raging Tide, 10:05 Eastern tomorrow morning. Tonight, join Billy Graham for a message of inspiration and hope. The Billy Graham Crusade. Tonight at 10:20 Eastern on the Superstation.
From the Headline News Network, this is Newswatch.
Headline News, I'm Bobby Batista. Chrysler, the nation's third largest automaker, is moving to buy number five, American Motors. Chairman Lee Iacocca announced today that Chrysler has signed a letter of intent to buy Renault's 46% interest in AMC. The plan must be approved by the French and U.S. governments, the board of directors of all three companies, and AMC stockholders. Piedmont Aviation Incorporated has agreed to a $1.59 billion buyout offer from U.S. Air. U.S. Air has agreed to maintain Piedmont as a wholly owned subsidiary for at least a year before possibly absorbing the company. The deal was to have gone through last week, but was delayed by an unfriendly U.S. Air takeover attempt by TWA. Well, it's looking more and more like human error is behind the capsizing of a British ferry. A company spokesman confirms reports that a crew member is blaming himself for Friday's disaster, saying he failed to lock the bow doors properly. 53 bodies have been recovered, 81 are missing and presumed dead. John Donovan has more.
The wounded ferry lies still on the seafloor, halfway out of the water. Its bow doors still gape open, but covered now with a netting to prevent any more of its contents from spilling out. On Monday morning, the ship was undergoing another inspection by salvage crews, who had already moved cranes into the area so they can start the job that eventually will lead to standing the ship up straight again. Temperatures out here are bitterly cold, but the weather was clear, which greatly simplifies the work the salvagers have to do.
But getting this ship upright is not a matter of days. It's more like a matter of weeks. And until then, most of the bodies caught inside will probably have to stay there.
The dead were remembered on Monday morning at a ceremony in Zeebrugge, a church services attended by a prince of the Belgian royal family, as well as diplomats and local dignitaries. Out at sea, meanwhile, ferries continue to run their normal routes. Entering Zeebrugge on Monday was this ferry, another from the same fleet involved in Friday's accident. This one had its bow doors shut tightly. John Donvan, CNN, Zeebrugge, Belgium.
Criminal charges could be pending against some current and former Reagan administration officials in connection with the Iran-Contra affair. Today's New York Times says that independent counsel Lawrence Walsh is expanding his criminal probe. Quoting law enforcement officials, the paper says investigators are focusing on three specific felonies: conspiracy to defraud the government, obstruction of justice, and making false statements to the government. The Times says Walsh has not ruled out any suspects, including senior administration officials. Well, President Reagan has a busy day planned, intended to put the Iran arms affair behind him. A week after coming out of relative isolation, he is meeting with Republican Party leaders today for what one aide calls a cheerleading session. The president has also planned talks with advisors to map out legislative strategy. Well, New York Congressman Jack Kemp says early next month he will officially announce that he is running for president. Kemp got a jump on the campaigning this weekend with a visit to New Hampshire. Tom Minty reports.
New York Congressman Jack Kemp may be the Republican conservatives' version of a white knight, but as political observers like to say, his campaign has yet to catch fire.
Thank you very much.
At the 84 Republican convention in Dallas, it appeared Kemp was ready. But now in the New Hampshire snow, the cheering has faded. Kemp is well behind Vice President George Bush and Senator Bob Dole in the polls, but says the political season is still early.
I've got a big job ahead of me, but I am convinced that the race is wide open, that I'm competitive, and that the ideas are very popular.
Those ideas are mostly economic ideas. At this meeting of supporters in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, it sounded like a course in economics.
The producer price index last year was off by 2%, and the prime rate is 7 or even higher.
But Kemp says talking about money is important, and most people understand it.
The common, everyday, hardworking men and women and families of America understand that taxes should be low, money should be sound and honest, interest rate should be low, The economy should be booming.
While most political events in New Hampshire are small groups, Representative Kemp was able to draw even a larger audience at a spaghetti dinner in a church basement.
Looks like a middle linebacker.
But the candidate has little control of the event. Here's how Jack Kemp, the Republican, was introduced. Kemp didn't call the mistake to anyone's attention. He went right on shaking hands. Apparently, he knows it's early, and New Hampshire voters are still trying to figure out who all these strangers are showing up for dinner. Tom Mintier, CNN, Manchester, New Hampshire.
Israeli law officials admit they had a policeman pose as a fellow inmate to see if accused Nazi war criminal John Demjanjuk would admit to any crimes. The chief police interrogator testified in Jerusalem today that no confession was obtained. Demjanjuk's attorneys are charging that his rights were violated after he was extradited to Israel. Cross went off the FBI's 10 most wanted list. Brian Christie reports on yesterday's arrest of fugitive Claude Dallas, captured in California after 11 months on the run.
Even though he vowed not to be taken alive, Claude Dallas was captured without trouble as he left a convenience store in Riverside, California. Authorities say he was using the alias Al Schrank and at first denied he was Dallas until a fingerprint check at the county jail proved it. He had been staying at a motel in Riverside, and lawmen say he had friends in the area. Dallas had been on the run for almost a year. He escaped from the Idaho State Penitentiary, where he was serving a 30-year term. He was convicted of the 1981 murder of two Idaho Fish and Game wardens who were trying to arrest him for poaching. Both were killed by rifle bullets to the head. 3,000 wanted posters went up at law enforcement agencies across the country. The posters included two mugshots and a sketch of the 36-year-old Dallas. Even though he was a convicted killer, he became a folk hero. Many people admired him as a member of the modern-day Old West. A television movie was made of his life on the run. Claude Dallas was arrested on a fugitive warrant Sunday and is being held at the Riverside County, California jail. Brian Christie, CNN, reporting.
A shocking majority of the nation's children reportedly will fall victim to violent crime at some point during their lifetimes. Susan Rook looks at a new Justice Department study on crime.
A new Justice Department study predicts an alarming number of today's children will become tomorrow's victims of violent crime. The report says 83% of today's 12-year-olds will be victims or intended victims at some point in their lives. About half will be victimized twice or more. In addition, about 2 in every 5 of the nation's young people are likely to be injured in a robbery or assault. 1 in 10 injured more than once. The study's based on figures compiled by the government's National Crime Survey from 1975 to 1984 and was drawn from about 2 million interviews. According to the report, race and sex affect the chances of becoming a victim. The study showed black males have a 45% chance of becoming a victim 3 or more times. White males, a 37% chance. Black females, 24%. And white females, 13%. An estimated 3 in 10 people will be victims of a robbery or attempted robbery during their lifetimes, with blacks almost twice as likely to be robbed as whites, and males about 70% more likely to be robbed than females. The Justice Department predicts 1 out of every 12 females will be raped in her lifetime. The odds rise to 1 in 9 for black females. The report goes on to say the chance of becoming a victim declines with age and predicts if violent crime continues to fall, the likelihood of becoming a victim will also decrease. Susan Rook, CNN, reporting.
We'll be back in a moment.
Mama, don't let your babies grow up to be cowards.
No singer today is more loved than Willie Nelson.
Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks.
His voice touches your heart and soul with so much honesty. It's made him a living legend.
My heroes have always been cowboys.
Now, every one of Willie's number one hits are together for the very first time in this complete two-record collection, The Best of Willie Nelson.
On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. But you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Good morning, America. How
complete albums.
In twilight glow I see blue eyes crying in rain. All the better I'll say.
Here's your chance to get all of Willie's number one hits in this special collection.
Blue skies smile at me.
Remember, it's not sold in any store.
Georgia.
Please stay tuned to order now.
Georgia.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-257-1234. To save all COD and handling charges and pay only $12.98 for two albums, two cassettes, or two 8-tracks, send check or money order to Willie Nelson, P.O. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia. Remember, to save all additional charges, send only $12.98 to Willie Nelson, P.O. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia.
You want weekday morning comedy and a lovely lady? Well, you could have had Jeannie, but I booked her already on the Superstation. Hey, how about a bewitching blonde who... No, I booked her on the Superstation, too. Here's a gal who's really down to earth and booked solid on the Superstation. There's Lucy. I love Lucy so much that I booked her on the Superstation, too.
TV's most talented ladies are all on the Superstation, beginning at 8:05 Eastern weekdays.
You don't need me, babe. You need the Superstation.
Jury selection begins today in the trial of one of two men accused of killing the parents of Dallas star Patrick Duffy. Brad Johnson has details.
Terrence and Marie Duffy were shot to death last November at the tavern they'd owned for 36 years in the small Montana ranching town. 19-year-old teenagers Sean Wentz and Kenneth Miller are charged with two counts of homicide. Miller, who is going on trial today, will claim he was forced to take part in the crime by Wentz. Wentz, whose trial date has not been set, will base his defense on insanity.
Good morning.
Patrick Duffy, who made a successful return to Dallas this season, will not attend the trial. Duffy says his Buddhist belief helped him cope with the tragic loss of his parents, but also said his parents courted this type of trouble by working in a bar.
It's a very positive attitude inside, and I think that's strictly due to the very strong faith that he and his wife have. They're Buddhists, and it's a very, very positive in there, very unlike what you might suspect.
I think to lose your parents at any time in your life is a tragedy, but to lose them in such a vicious and mindless way is just incomprehensible.
He's a very strong fellow, and his family is very strong, and they'll get through this, I know.
On the weekend before their deaths, the Duffys were planning to sell the lounge and retire. Miller's trial is expected to last 2 weeks. He could receive the death penalty. The apparent motive for the killings, robbery, a crime which netted the suspects only $90. Brad Johnson, CNN, reporting.
Buffalo, New York police have charged two teenagers with the recent murders of two Roman Catholic priests. Yesterday, Monsignor David Herlihy was found stabbed and bound to a chair in a church rectory. On February 24th, Reverend Joseph Bissonnette was found stabbed and bound in a rectory 2 miles away. Police say robbery apparently motivated both killings. The National Rifle Association is united when it comes to the subject of crime prevention, but as Mary Tillotson reports, the ranks of the NRA are becoming increasingly divided on policy matters.
The combativeness NRA members usually direct at gun control advocates, they're turning on each other these days. A group of Rifle Association dissidents claims NRA has lost more than 300,000 members since last spring because NRA officials were too willing to compromise when Congress debated federal gun controls. Dissident leader Neil Knox says he should be NRA's top executive officer so the group's nearly 3 million members will get the tough anti-gun control lobbying they want.
That group, when it speaks, should be heard. And we don't have to go to Congress hat in hand.
Rifle Association officials insist NRA membership has declined by fewer than 40,000, and they say the drop is partly because membership qualifications have been tightened. But gun control advocates interpret the drop in NRA rolls differently. They say that when people like Sarah Brady, wife of wounded White House aide Jim Brady, and police officers from all over the country lobbied last year for gun controls, it made some NRA members rethink what their dues were buying.
We've been trying to tell people for years, look closely at what this organization is doing. They're not out there representing the interests of the average American hunter or shooter. They're out there representing the interests of the gun makers, of the gun dealers, of those people who want to be able to buy machine guns, Saturday night specials, and silencers.
There may be some hint at NRA's annual meeting about whether the association's strength has been diminished. But the real test will come where it always does, in the halls of Congress, in NRA's next battle against tighter gun laws. Mary Tillotson, CNN, Washington.
A New York University researcher is warning Congress today that destruction of the Earth's ozone layer is increasing skin cancer cases to near epidemic proportions. Ozone provides a sort of sunscreen for humans.
For the Headline News Network, 24 hours a day, call your cable operator.
Tuesday, private eyes are watching you. Dean Martin, he's the sexy, mischievous secret agent, Mad Helm. Murderers Row, 11:20 Eastern on the Superstation, Tuesday night.